today is December 9th, 2015 on Satan's calendar. It is the 1335th day of Yehweh's servant Daniel's chapter 12 prophecy. This prophecy tells us in verse 12, "Blessed is he that waits and touches, that lays hands upon or conquers 1335 days. My hands have indeed touched upon this day." They have not only touched this day, they have seized upon it in the same manner that my hands have seized upon Yehweh's great name that he has sent me to bear witness to. My hands have seized upon who he is. They have seized upon his righteousness. And they have seized upon every word that he has sent forth from his mouth, like his servants Moses and his only begotten son told us we must do. And he has indeed blessed me for doing so. But have you stood with his servant for these 1,335 days? No, only my wife and daughter have endured with me for this period of time. As far as being blessed, the testimony of his word testifies that I will not even taste death. Not only has he testified to this in a precept upon precept, measuring line upon measuring line, here a little, there a little way, he has also expressed this wonderful blessing through one of his psalms. In Psalms chapter 118, "I will not die, I will live, for I have declared Yehweh's works. Yehweh has chastised me, but Yehweh has not given me to death." He has even carried this burden for me during this period of time because I have trusted in him to do so and because I have obeyed his voice. In verse 19, "He will open wide the gates of righteousness unto me, and I will go into them, confessing Yehweh." The testimony of his word testifies that this 1,335th day is the day that he will begin to open wide my mouth and to cause his word that he has placed upon my mouth to no longer be put to silence. And this psalm parallels this. In verse 20, "This is Yehweh's gate that the righteous enter into. For I have confessed you, and you will answer me and be my salvation. The builders have despised or rejected the stone that became the head and the corner." You were supposed to help Yehweh build his temple, his eternal family. But instead you have rejected and despised the headstone and the cornerstone that he sent to you to follow after. You have rejected and despised who his only begotten son is. And you have fashioned him into who your rebellious, uncircumcised hearts want for him to be. Yeshua was manifested to us in the image of his Father's word. The image of Yehweh's word is pure righteousness. In verse 23, this, referring to making his only begotten Son in his image, in the image of his word, is Yehweh's doing. He, the headstone and the cornerstone, is wondrous or separate in his eyes, in Yehweh's eyes. Yeshua being the headstone, the cornerstone of Yehweh's temple, flows into the one stone, the last stone of his temple that he has sent to us at this time. A cornerstone establishes the blueprint of a building. It lays it out. The blueprint of Yehweh's temple is his word. In verse 24, this, referring to the here and the now, the day that the Most High servant is sent to declare these things, the day that this servant is not going to taste death, is the day that Yehweh has made. Rejoice and be glad in it. Concerning this servant, his Zechariah chapter 4 prophecy tells us in chapter 4, we'll start in verse 8, "Yehweh's word came to me saying, the foundation of this house," referring to the foundation of Yehweh's house, his temple of first fruits, the foundation is symbolic of the measuring rod that his temple was built with, his word. "The foundation of this house is in the hands of Zerubbabel, the one who would flow out from the captivity of mystery Babylon at the end of this era of time. And his hands will seize it. His hands will seize Yehweh's measuring rod and his house that it built with determination. And you will know that Yehweh of hosts has sent him to you." In the coming days, the Most High is going to show you that he has opened wide my mouth and he is going to cause you to know this. In verse 10, "For who has despised or who has disrespect for or contempt for the day of small things?" The day of the small cloud of his Elijah prophecy that it is going to mushroom before your faces. The day of not by might nor by power, but by his seven spirits is going to come to an end. And those of you who are high and lifted up before the Most High's face are going to become a plain before this Zerubbabel's face. His word says so. Rejoice when you see the measuring line, or Yehweh's word, the foundation of his house, in the hands of Zerubbabel, with his seven spirits. They are Yehweh's eyes that run to and fro throughout the whole earth. But you have not rejoiced, nor did you rejoice in his first witness. Instead, you made him in the image, in your image, and you have rejoiced in your make-believe Messiah that is the work of your own hands. Back to Psalms 118, I beseech you, Yehweh, to deliver now. This is a request for the here, the now. I have beseeched Yehweh to set the captives free at this time. Yehweh, I beseech you to prosper now. I have beseeched him to cause that which he has spoken, that his word tells us will happen at this time, to prosper now. Verse 21 tells us that he is going to answer this servant. Verse 26, bless him that comes in Yehweh's name. Bless Yehweh's house. He is going to answer me because he has sent me in his name. Yehweh's word tells us that the inhabitants of Jerusalem blessed his only begotten son when Yeshua came in his name. They rejoiced, but only temporarily when his father sent him in his name. The multitude spread their garments in the road, and they also cut down branches of trees and spread them in the road, and they cried out, Hosanna to the Son of David, and they said, Blessed is he that comes in Yehweh's name. Hosanna means, I beseech you to save us. But then they heard his witness against them, and except for a few of them in number, they joined in with the religious hypocrites of that day in wanting for him to be put to death 4 days' journey later. 4 days' journey from today is the 10th day of the 10th month on Yehweh's restored calendar. This is the day that Yehweh empowered his servant Nebuchadnezzar to come against Jerusalem. It is also the day that he gave to us for his Ezekiel chapter 24 Son of Man prophecy. This prophecy is the Most High's promise to us that he has plucked me from the captivity of mystery Babylon, from your midst, and made me to be his end time Son of Man. This waypoint is 90 days prior to the 10th day of the first month. The 10th day of the first month is the day that Yeshua rode into Jerusalem on the ass's colt, and the people cried out, Hosanna, and cried out, Blessed is he that comes in Yehweh's name. The last verse of Yehweh's Ezekiel chapter 24 prophecy is one of the four places that he tells us that he is going to open wide my mouth. 21 days after this waypoint will be the first day of the 11th month. This is the day that Yehweh's servant Moses spoke all that Yehweh commanded at Horeb for us to do before our ancestors crossed over the Jordan at that time. They crossed over the Jordan on the 10th day of the first month, the same day that Yeshua rode into Jerusalem. The significance of 21 days is spoken about in several other videos. Moving forward from today's 1,335th day, from a chronological point of view, the third of these four waypoints will be the first day of the first month. I have spoken about the significance of this waypoint in several of these videos as well. This is a huge day in Yehweh's end time timeline and what it represents. And the last one of these four waypoints will occur before the final 7 days of this period of time will be the fifth day of the fourth month. This will be 6 months before half a time before the last 7 days of the great and the fearful day of Yehweh that will begin on the fifth day of the 10th month next year. 2 Kings chapter 25 tells us that the famine prevailed in Jerusalem 4 days' journey from the fifth day of the fourth month after Nebuchadnezzar came against Jerusalem on the 10th day of the 10th month. Jeremiah chapter 39 tells us that this 4 days' journey waypoint is also the day that the city was breached. At that time, the ninth day of the fourth month, which was 4 days' journey from the fifth day, was nearly 1 year and 6 months after the 10th day of the 10th month. However, at this time, Yehweh is going to make a shortened work of this gap in time. He is going to do so because he has shortened the days per his only begotten son's prophecy that he was going to do so at this time. Counting today, there are 360 days until the first day of the final 7 days of the great and the fearful day of Yehweh. The dynamics that are contained in there being 360 days per year, the way that the Most High ordained the rotations in the heavens before He altered them during the days of His servant Isaiah and Hezekiah, are awesome. This period of time can be divided into 12 30-day months, one for each of the 12 rods of Israel that He built His first fruits from, or this can be reversed into 30 12-day periods of time. It can be divided into 9 40-day periods of time, one 40-day period for each of the 9 months that it takes for a woman to bring forth a child. It can also be divided into 6 60-day periods, one for each of His 6 work weeks that are contained in His 7-day work weeks. It can be divided into 4 90-day periods. The Most High used 2 mirroring 90-day periods on each side of the scattering of the last one-third of my hair to establish His restoration of His 30-day months. The scattering of my hair was per His Ezekiel chapter 5 Son of Man prophecy. 360 days can also be divided into 2 half of times or 3 120-day periods of time. He caused His servant Moses to live for 120 years at the time of the first Exodus. The dynamics that are contained in these parallels and even others that I'm not even mentioning are incredible, but they are not the subject of this video. However, I do want to point out that Yehweh led man to measure a circle with 360 degrees. These coming 360 days will bring the testimony of His word that He has sent me with full circle. And you will know that there has been a prophet amongst you. His word says so. If you want for the Most High to bless you during this time of affliction by delivering you through it and planting you in the millennium, you are going to have to stop bearing His name in a desolating way and start bearing His name in truth. You are going to have to start bearing His righteousness that His name represents. You are going to have to learn that man shall not live by bread alone, but rather by every word that has been sent forth from Yehweh Elohim's mouth. And you are going to have to do so. You are going to have to live by every word that He sent forth from His mouth. Or else, dying you will die. Thus saith Yehweh's word that is upon His servant Zerubbabel, that He has sent to you in His name.